Blessed is our God, always, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. O Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, be merciful to our sins. Master, pardon our transgressions. Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for your name's sake. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. Κυριε Λέησον, δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Αγίου Πνεύματι, και νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Δεύτε προσκυνήσουμεν και προσπέσουμεν το Βασιλεί μον Θεό. Δεύτε προσκυνήσουμεν και προσπέσουμεν Χριστό το Βασιλεί μον Θεό. Δεύτε προσκυνήσουμεν και προσπέσουμεν αυτό Χριστό το Βασιλεί και Θεό εμών. Κύριε, εισάκουσον της προσευχής μου, ενώτησι την δέησή μου εν τη αληθεία σου, εισάκουσον μου εν τη δικαιοσύνη σου, και μη εισέλθησες κρίσιν μετά του δούλου σου, ότι ου δικαιωθήσετε ενώπιόν σου πας ζών, ότι κατεδίωξεν ο εχθρός την ψυχήν μου, εταπείνωσεν εις γήν την ζωήν μου, εκάθισέ με εν σκοτεινήσως νεκρούς αιώνος, και η κηδίασεν επί με το πνεύμα μου, εν εμή εταράχθη η καρδία μου, εμείς την ημερών αρχαίων μελέτησα εν πάση της έργη σου, εν ποίημαση των χειρών σου εμελέτων, διεπέτασα προς ετασχύρας μου η ψυχή μου ως γη ανιδρώση. Ταχύ εισάκουσόν μου, Κύριε, εξέλιπε το πνεύμα μου, μη αποστρέψεις το προσωπόν σου επ' εμού και ομοιωθήσου με τις καταβαίνουσιν εις λάγων. Άκουστον ποιησόν με το πρωί το ελαιό σου, ότι επισύλπισα. Γνώρισον μου, Κύριε, οδόν ανυπορεύσομαι, ότι προσέειρα την ψυχή μου. Εξελούμε εκ των εχθρών μου, Κύριε, προσέ κατέφυγον. Δίδαξον με το ποιήν του θέλημά σου, ότι εσύ, ο Θεός μου, το πνεύμα σου το αγαθόν οδηγήσει με εν γη ευθεία. Ένε και εν του ονοματό σου, Κύριε, ζήσεις με. Εν τη δικαιοσύνη σου εξάξεις εθλίψεως την ψυχή μου, και εν το ελέη σου εξολοθρεύσεις τους εχθρούς μου, και απολύεις πάντα στους θλίβοντας την ψυχή μου, ότι εγώ ο δούλου σου είμαι.
Έτι και έτι εν ειρήνη του Κυρίου δεηθώμεν. Αντιλαβούς όσων ελέησον και διαφύλαξον ημάς ο Θεός της η χάρη της Παναγίας Αχράντο υπερευλογημένης εν δόξου δεσποινής ημών Θεοτόκου και αη Παρθένου Μαρίας, με τα πάντων των Αγίων μνημονεύσαντες σε αυτούς και αλλήλους και πάσαν την ζωήν ημών, Χριστό το Θεό παραθώμεθα. Ότι ελεήμων και φιλάνθρωπος Θεός υπάρχεις και εσύ την δόξα να αναπέμπομαι, το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Άγιο Πνεύματι νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν. Αλληλούια. Discipline me in your wrath. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Eleison me, Kyrie, oti asthenissimi. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Have mercy on us, O Lord, have mercy on us. For with nothing to say in our own defense, we sinners offer this supplication to your Master. Have mercy on us.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Άγιο Πνεύματι, Κύριε ελέησον ημάς, επισήγαρ πεποίθαμεν, μη οργιστείς ημίν σφόδρα, μη δευνηστείς των ανομιών ημών, αλλά επίβλεψον και νύνος εύσπλαχνος, και λύτρωσε ημάς εκ των εχθρών ημών, σίγαρη Θεός ημών και ημείς λαός σου, πάντα στο όνομά σου, έργα χειρών σου και επί και κλείμεθα.
Both now and forever into the ages of ages, amen. Open the gate of compassion for us, O blessed Theotokos. For hoping in you, let us not fail in our aim. Through you we may be delivered from adversities, for you are the salvation of the Christian faith.
Have mercy on me, O God, according to your great mercy, and according to the abundance of your compassion, blot out my transgression. Wash me thoroughly from my lawlessness and cleanse me from my sin, for I know my lawlessness and my sin is always before me. Against you only have I sinned and done evil in your sight, that you may be justified in your words and overcome when you are judged. For behold, I was conceived in transgressions, and in sins my mother bore me. Behold, you love truth. You showed me the unknown and secret things of your wisdom. You shall sprinkle me with hyssop, and I shall be cleansed. You shall wash me, and I will be made whiter than snow. You shall make me hear joy and gladness. My bones that were humbled shall greatly rejoice. Turn your face from my sins and blot out all my transgressions. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Do not cast me away from your presence, and do not take your Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation, and uphold me with your guiding spirit. I will teach transgressors your ways, and the ungodly shall turn back to you. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God, the God of my salvation, and my tongue shall greatly rejoice in your righteousness. O Lord, you shall open my lips, and my mouth will declare your praise. For if you desired sacrifice, I would give it. You will not be pleased with whole burnt offerings. A sacrifice to God is a broken spirit, a broken and humbled heart God will not despise. Do good, O Lord, in your good pleasure to Zion, and let the walls of Jerusalem be built. Then you will be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness, with offerings and whole burnt offerings. Then they shall offer young bulls on your altar.
Theotokos, Master Christ, have mercy on your servants. The unction of your compassion ever cheers the souls and bodies alike of us, your servants, Master, and with oil you protect the believers all. So now to us who come to you, your holy unction be all merciful.
Δέσποτα Χριστέ, ελέησον τους δούλους σου, υπάρχει σου του ελέους δέσποτα πληρείς η σύμπασα γη, όθεν ελεωθεί ο μυστικός, η κρυώμενη σήμερον, τον υπερνούν σου ελεών, πίστοσε του μεν σε δοθεί νέοι μη.
Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. O Lord, you commanded your apostles to anoint with holy oil your ailing servant sympathetically as the friend of humanity. So now have mercy on us all at their entreaties by your seal on us.
Η μόνη το της ειρήνης πέλαγος αγνή πλουτίσασα, τες προς Θεόν πρεσβείες σου αη, νοσημάτων και θλίψεων, του σου σηκέτας λύτρωσε, όπως ο πάστος μεγαλύνωσε.
Master Christ, have mercy on your servants. You only are wonderful, and you have pity on believers all. Therefore, O Christ, give your grace from on high to those who are grievously sick.
Δέσποτα Χριστέ, ελέησον τους δούλους σου, ελέας καρφός ποτέ προς ανοχήν κατακλυσμού θεία σου. Δείξας ροπή, Κύριες, όσον εν ελέη τους κάμνοντας.
Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. With faith in your mercy, Lord, for holy unction we have earnestly come. With your divine lamp of light, in your mercy brighten us, Christ our God.
Και νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων, αμήν. Επιβλέψον ευμενός, μητήρ του πάντων ποιη του ανώθεν. Και την πικράν κακοσύν, λύσουν τους νοσούντας πρεσβείες σου.
Ο Ως θείος ποταμός του ελαιούς υπάρχων, ως άβυσσος πολύ συμπαθίας ικτήρμων, δείξον του σου ελαιούς τα θεία ρήθρα και πάντα σιάσε. Βλύσσοντας των θαμάτων πήγας αυθόνος και πλύνων απάντας. Σίγαρ αΐ προστρέχοντες θερμός, την χάριν εξετούμεθα.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Αγίω Πνεύματι,
και νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν.
Ο Ιατρός και Βοηθός των εν πονείς, ο Λυτρωτίστε και Σωτήρ των ενώσεις, Αυτός των όλων Δέσποτα και Κύριε, δώρησε την ίασιν της νοσούς Ιησού δούλης, ικτήρων ελέησον τους πολλά επτεκώτας και των σφαλμάτων λύτρωσε Χριστέ, όπως δοξάζωσι την Θείαν σου δύναμη.
Ελέους πηγή υπάρχον υπεράγαθε τους πίστη θερμή, ελέη το αφάτο σου, προσπεσώντας έσπλαχνε, εκ παντίας λύτρωσε κακώσεως, και τας αυτόν όσου αράμενος, παράσχου την θείαν χάριν άνωθεν.
Αιγετός, Master Christ, have mercy on your servants, lover of mankind, look from heaven, display your mercy on your servants, give your mighty help and assistance to all who come to you through this sacrament to be anointed by your priests with holy unction, O compassionate.
Δέσποτα Χριστέ, ελέησον τους δούλους σου, είδομην παν αγαθέ εσώτε, αγαλλιόμενοι το Θείον, ελέον ροπή σου εν Θεό υπερμετόχους, όπερ προσήλυφας και τυπικός μετέδοκας, λουτρού του Θείου της μετέχουση.
Glory to the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Pity us, have mercy, O Savior. Deliver us from pain and peril. Rescue us, your servant, soul and body, for we are targets of the devil's arrows. But since you are the merciful Lord, heal us thoroughly by divine grace.
Και νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων, αμήν. Ύμνους και δεήσεις παρθένε, προσδεχομένοι των σονδούλων, ρίσε χαλεπών παθημάτων και αλγιδώνων, τεσί και σίεσου, τους δήμων πανάγραντε, τη θεία σκέπη σου προστρέχοντας.
Αξιώνες θύνος αλήθως, μακαρίζεσαι την Θεοτόκον, την Ναή μακάριστον και παναμόμητον, και μητέρα του Θεού ημών, την τιμιωτέρα των χερούβιν και ενδοξωτέρα να συγκρίτως των σεραφείμ, την αδιαφθόρος Θεόν λόγον τεκούσαν, την όντως Θεοτόκον σε
Let us again pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Remembering our all holy, pure, most blessed, glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, Let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
To you, O Lord.
For all the powers of heaven praise you and offer up glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever and to the ages of ages.
Τον εσπυλωμένον πάσε τους αμαρτίες και καταγωγιών τερπνών της υπερθέου Τριάδος πίσων, όπως την δυναστεία σου και το αμέτρητον έλεος, μεγαλήνους σωζόμενος ο άγριος ηκέτης σου.
Holy God, holy mighty, holy mortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy mortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy mortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. All Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, forgive our sins. Master, pardon our transgressions. Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for your name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For yours is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Christ, you alone are he who quickly comes to our aid. We pray that you show your quick response from heaven to your servants who are suffering. Free them from their diseases, relieve the pain that afflicts them, raise them that they may ceaselessly give glory and extol you. By the prayers of the Theotokos, only lover of humanity.
In peace let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For peace from above and the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For peace in the whole world, the stability of the holy churches of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house and for those who enter it with faith, reverence, and fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our Archbishop Makarios, for the honorable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, and for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this country, its civil authorities, and all its people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the people in attendance who anticipate the grace of the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord. That this oil will be blessed by the descent, power, and energy of the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the servants of God who are attending this holy sacrament from near and afar, and that God will visit them, and that the grace of the Holy Spirit will come upon them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all affliction, anger, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Commemorating our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
To you, O Lord.
For to you belong all glory, honor, and worship, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us pray to the
Lord. Lord, have mercy.
O Lord, when your mercy and bounties heal the disorders of our souls and bodies, Sanctify this oil so that those who shall be anointed with it may be healed and freed from every passion, illness of body, uncleanness of flesh and spirit, and from all evils, that in this too your all-holy name may be glorified, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. O Christ, you alone are he who quickly comes to our aid. We pray that you show your quick response from heaven to your servants who are suffering. Free them of their diseases, relieve the pain that afflicts them, raise them that they may ceaselessly give glory and extol you. By the prayers of the Theotokos, only lover of humanity.
Της ψυχής τα όματα πεπειρωμένος, Συ Χριστέ προσέρχομαι, ως ο τυφλός εκγενετής, εν μετανοία κραυγάζομαι, Συ τον εν σκότην, το φως το υπερλαμπρόν.
I have sinned in every way, I have improperly acted, therefore with paralysis my soul is woefully stricken.
When God the Logos, as the only begotten of God the Father, came and sojourned among us, in latter days, O God-inspired brother of the Lord, he appointed you, O James, the first shepherd and teacher of holy Jerusalem and a trustworthy steward of the all-holy sacraments, and hence, O just apostle, we honor your memory. Champion, fortifying us in times of danger and defeating our foes, O victorious one. So as you humbled Leo's arrogance by giving courage to Nestor in the stadium, thus, O holy great martyr Dimitrios, to Christ God pray fervently, beseeching him to grant us his great mercy.
Αθλοφόρε Αγίε και ιωματί και παντελεήμων πρέσβευε το ελεήμων η Θεό ειν απτεσμάτων άφεσιν παράσχητες ψυχές ημών.
Αγία Ναργυρή και Θαυματούρη επισκέψαστε τους ασθενείς δωρεάν ελάβετε, δωρεάν δώτε ημίν.
Who can recount all your mighty deeds, O Virgin Saint John? You pour out miracles, and you overflow with cures, and you intercede on behalf of our souls as a theologian and friend of Christ.
O Mother of God, intently we cry out to you, the wellspring of mercy and the refuge of the world, O vehement advocate, unassailable fortress, anticipate, and deliver us from perilous ordeals, O Lady.
Let us attend.
Let your mercy, O Lord, be upon us. Rejoice greatly in the Lord, O righteous ones.
Wisdom.
The reading is from James's universal letter.
Let us be attentive.
Brethren, take as an example of suffering and patience the prophets who spoke in the name of the Lord. Behold, we call those happy who were steadfast. You have heard of the steadfastness of Job, and you have seen the purpose of the Lord, how the Lord is compassionate and merciful. But above all, my brethren, do not swear either by heaven or by earth, or with any other oath, but let your yes be yes, and your no be no, that you may not fall under condemnation. Is anyone among you suffering? Let him pray. Is any cheerful? Let him sing praise. Is any among you sick? Let him call for the elders of the church, and let them pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord, and the prayer of faith will save the sick man, and the Lord will raise him up, and if he has committed sins, he will be forgiven. Therefore confess your sins to one another, and pray for one another, that you may be healed. The prayer of a righteous man has great power in its effect.
Peace be with you.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Wisdom, arise, let us hear the holy gospel. Peace be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Εκ του κατά Λουκάν Αγίου Ευαγγελίου το ανάγνωσμα πρόσχομεν.
Δόξα σοι, Κύριε, δόξα σοι.
Το καιρό εκείνο νομικός της προσήλθε το Ιησού εκ πειράζων αυτών και λέγον, διδάσκαλε τι ποιοί σας ζωήν αιώνιον κληρονομήσω. Ο δε είπε προς αυτόν, εν τον νόμο τι γεγραπτέ, πώς αναγινώσκεις. Ο δε αποκριθείς είπεν, αγαπήσεις Κύριον τον Θεόν σου εξ όλης της καρδίας σου και εξ όλης της ψυχής σου και εξ όλης της ισχύος σου και εξ όλης της διανοίας σου και των πλησίων σου ως εαυτόν. Είπε δε αυτό, ορθώς απεκρίθης, τούτο ποιεί και ζήσεις. Ο δε θέλων δικαιούν εαυτόν, είπε προς τον Ιησούν, και τι σε στήμου πλησίον. Υπολαβών δε ο Ιησούς είπεν, άνθρωπος της κατέβαινε από Ιερουσαλήμ εις Ιεριχώ και ληστές περιέπεσεν.
ή και εκδίσαντες αυτών και πληγάς επιθέντες απήλθον, αφέντες οι μηθανοί την χάνοντα. Κατά συγκυρίαν δε ιερεύστης κατέβαινεν εν διωδώ εκείνη και ειδών αυτών αντιπαρήλθεν. Ομοίως δε και Λεβίτης, γενόμενος κατά των τόπων, ελθών και ειδών αντιπαρήλθε. Σαμαρίτης δε της οδεύων, ήλθε κατά αυτόν και ειδών αυτόν εσπλαχνίστη, και προσελθών κατέδισε τα τραύματα αυτού, επιχέων έλεον και ίνων. Επιβιβάσας δε αυτόν, επί το ίδιον κτίνος, ήγα γένης πανδοχείων και επεμελήθη αυτού. Και επί την αύριον εξελθών εκβαλών δύο δινάρια έδωκε το πανδοχή και είπεν αυτό, επιμελήθητη αυτού και ό,τι αν προσδαπανήσεις, εγώ εν το επανέρχεσθε με αποδόσωση. Τίσουν τούτων των τριών πλησίων δοκίσει γεγονένε του εμπεσόντος εις τους ληστάς, ο δε είπεν, ο ποιήσας το έλεος μεταυτού. Είπεν ουν αυτό Ιησούς, πορεύουν και εσύ ποι ομοιώς.
Δόξα σοι, Κύριε, δόξα σοι.
Ελέησον ημάς ο Θεός κατά το μέγα ελέος σου δεωμεθά σου επάκουσον και ελέησον.
Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον.
We pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, remission of sins for the servants of God, all devout and orthodox Christians who are attending this holy sacrament from near or afar, that they may be forgiven their every transgression, whether deliberate or unintended.
Lord, have mercy. Mercy, Lord, have mercy.
For you are a merciful and loving God, and to you we offer glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
O Lord, who are eternal, without beginning, holy of holies, who sent down your only begotten Son to heal every infirmity and every wound of our souls and bodies, send down your Holy Spirit and sanctify this oil, and cause it to be for your servants who are about to be anointed with it, unto complete remission of their sins, and unto inheritance of the kingdom of heaven. For you are a great and marvelous God, who keeps your covenant and your mercy to them who love you, who grants remission of sins through your divine Son, Jesus Christ. You gave us rebirth from sin. You give light to the blind and raise up the fallen. You love the righteous and show mercy to sinners. You renew us from darkness and the shadow of death, saying to those in captivity, come forth, and to those in darkness, uncover your eyes. For the light of knowledge of your only begotten Son has shined in our hearts, since for our sakes he revealed himself upon earth and dwelt among men. And unto as many as accepted him, he gave the power to become children of God, granting us the adoption of sonship through the laver of regeneration, and setting us free from the oppression of the devil. And inasmuch as it has not pleased that you, as it has not pleased you that we should be cleansed by blood, but by holy oil, you gave us the sign of his cross, that we might become the flock of Christ, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, purifying us by water and sanctifying us by your Holy Spirit. O Master and Lord, grant grace to this your ministry, as you did to Moses your servant, and to Samuel your beloved, and to John your chosen one, and to all those who from generation to generation have pleased you. In like manner, empower us also to be ministers of the new covenant of your Son over this oil, which you have secured through his precious blood, that putting away earthly desires, we may die unto sin, but live in righteousness being clothed with our Lord Jesus Christ through the anointing with this sanctifying oil, which we are about to summon to our aid. O Lord, grant that this oil becomes the oil of gladness, the oil of sanctification, a royal robe, an armor of might, the deflecting of every satanic assault, the seal of immunity from snares, gladness of heart, everlasting joy, that also in this they who shall be anointed with this oil of rebirth may be strong against their adversaries and may shine in the radiance of your saints, having neither spot nor wrinkle, and that they may be admitted into your eternal rest and receive the award of the calling from above. For yours it is to show mercy and to save us, O our God, and to you we offer glory, to the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Πρόσκομεν.
Ισχύς μου και ύμνησής μου ο Κύριος και γένετο μη σωτηρίαν, παιδεύον επαιδεύσέ με ο Κύριος και το θανάτου παρέδοκέμε.
Σοφία.
Προς Ρωμαίους επιστολής Παύλου το ανάγνωσμα.
Πρόσχομεν.
Αδελφοί, οφείλομεν εμείς οι δυνατοί τα ασθενήματα των αδυνάτων βαστάζειν και μη εαυτής αρέσκειν. Έκαστος γαρημών το πλησίον αρεσκέτο εις το αγαθόν προς οικοδομήν και γάρο Χριστός ούχε αυτό ήρεσεν. Αλλά καθώς γέγραπτε ιονίδισμοι των ονιδιζόντων σε πέπεσον επέμε. Όσα γαρ προεγράφει εις την ημετέραν διδασκαλίαν προεγράφει είναι αδειά της υπομονής και της παρακλήσεως των γραφών την ελπίδα έχομεν. Ο δε Θεός της υπομονής και της παρακλήσεως δω ήμην το αυτόφρονην εν αλλήλεις κατά Χριστόν Ιησούν. Είναι ομοθυμαδόν εν ενίστοματι δοξάζητε τον Θεόν και Πατέρα του Κυρίου ημών Ιησού Χριστού. Διό προσλαμβάνεστε αλλήλους καθώς και ο Χριστός προσελάβετο ημάς εις δόξαν Θεού. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Wisdom, let us arise, let us hear the holy gospel. Peace be with you all.
And with your spirit.
The reading is from the gospel according to Luke. Let us be attentive.
Glory to you, O Lord, glory to you.
At that time, Jesus entered Jericho and was passing through. And there was a man named Zacchaeus. He was a chief tax collector and rich. And he sought to see who Jesus was, but could not on account of the crowd, because he was small of stature. So he ran on ahead and climbed up into a sycamore tree to see him, for he was to pass that way. And when Jesus came to the place, he looked up and said to him, Zacchaeus, make haste and come down, for I must stay at your house today. So he made haste and came down and received him joyfully. And when they saw it, they all murmured, he has gone in to be the guest of a man who is a sinner. But Zacchaeus stood and said to the Lord, behold, Lord, the half of my goods I give to the poor, and if I have defrauded anyone of anything, I restore it fourfold. And Jesus said to him, today salvation has come to this house, since he also is a son of Abraham. For the Son of Man came to seek and to save the lost.
Glory to you, O Lord, glory to you.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
We pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, remission of sins for the servants of God, all devout and orthodox Christians who are attending this sacrament from near or afar, and that they may be forgiven their every transgression, whether deliberate or unintended.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
For you are a merciful and loving God, and to you we offer glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Άναρχε, αδιάδοχε, Άγιε, Αγίων, όταν ο μονογενής σου Υιόν εξ αποστήλας ιόμενον πάσα νόσων και πάσα ασθένειαν των ψυχών και των σωμάτων ημών, κατάπεμψον το Άγιον σου Πνεύμα και αγίασον το έλεον τούτο και ποίησον αυτό χρειωμένης της εις δούλης εις τελείαν απολύτρωσιν των αμαρτιών αυτών εις βασιλείας ουρανών κληρονομίαν. Σίγαρι ο Θεός, ο Μέγας και Θαυμαστός, οφυλάσσον την διαθήκην σου και το έλεο σου της αγαπώσισε. Ο διδούς λύτρος είναι αμαρτιών δια του Αγίου σου παιδός Ιησού Χριστού. Ο αναγεννήσας ημάς από τις αμαρτίας. Ο φωτίζων τους τυφλούς και ανορθών τους κατεραγμένους. Ο αγαπών τους δικαίους και τους αμαρτωλούς ελαιών. Ο ανακαινήσας ημάς εξ σκότους και σκιάς θανάτου λέγον της ενδεσμής. Εξέλθετε και της εν σκότη ανακαλύψαστε. Έλαμψε γάρεντες καρδίες ημών, το φως της επιγνώσεως του μονογενού σου Υιού, αφού διημάς επί της γης όρθης και της ανθρώπης συνανεστράφης, και της δεξαμένης αυτών έδωκαν εξουσία τέκνα σου του Θεού γενέστε, δια λουτρού παλιγενεσίας, την υιοθεσίαν ημίν χαρισάμενος, αμετόχους ημάς υπήησεν έκ της καταδυναστείας του διαβόλου, επίου και ευδόκησεν ενέματι καθαρίζεστε, αλενελαίο Αγίο εδώ και των τύπων του Σταυρού αυτού, εις το γενέστε ημάς Χριστού Πίμνιον, Βασίλειον Ιεράτευμα, Έθνος Άγιον, καθαρίσας ημάς εν ύδατη και αγιάσας εν το Αγίο Πνεύματι. Αυτός Δέσποτα Κύριε, δώσ' χάριν στην διακονία σου ταύτην, ως έδωκας Μωσή, το θεράποντί σου και Σαμουήλ το εγαπημένο σου και Ιωάννη το εκλεκτό σου. Και πάση της καθεκάστην γενεάν ευαρεστής ασύση. Ούτω ποιήσον και ημάς γενέστε διακόνους της κενής του Υιού σου Διαθήκης, επί το έλεον τούτο, όπερι ποιήσω το τιμίο αυτού αίματι, ή να αποδυσάμενη τας κοσμικάς επιθυμίας, αποθάνομεν τη αμαρτία και ζήσομεν τη δικαιοσύνη. Ενδυσάμενη τον Κύριον ημών Ιησούν Χριστόν, δια της χρήσεως του αγιωσμού του μέλλοντος ελαίου επάγεστε. Γέννη το Κύριε το έλεον τούτο, έλεον αγαλιάσεως, έλεον αγιασμού, ένδυμα βασιλικών, θώραξ δυνάμεως, πάσης διαβολικής ενεργίας αποτρόπαιων, σφραγής ανεπιβούλευτος, αγαλία μακαρδίας, εφροσύνη αιώνιος, είναι και εν τούτο εχριόμενη το της αναγεννήσεως ελαίο, φοβερή όση της υπεναντής και λάμψωσιν εν τες λαμπρότηση των Αγίων σου, μη έχοντες σπήλων ηρητίδα, και εις δεχόσιν εις τας αιωνίου σου αναπαύσεις και δέξονται το βραβείο της ανοκλήσεως. Σον γαρεστήν το ελέην και σώζην ημάς ο Θεός ημών, Συ την δόξα να αναπέμπομεν το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Αγίο Πνεύματι νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Let us attend.
The Lord is my light and my Savior, whom shall I fear? The Lord is the defender of my life, whom shall I dread?
Wisdom.
The reading is from Paul's first letter to the Corinthians.
Let us be attentive.
Brethren, you are the body of Christ and individually members of it. And God has appointed in the church first apostles, second prophets, third teachers, then workers of miracles, then healers, helpers, administrators, speakers in various kinds of tongues. Are all apostles, are all prophets, are all teachers, do all work miracles, do all possess gifts of healing, do all speak with tongues, do all interpret, but earnestly desire the higher gifts. And I will show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels but have not love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all the mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give away all I have, and if I deliver my body to be burned, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends.
Peace be with you, the reader.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Sophia Ορθή, ακούσμεν του Αγίου Ευαγγελίου, ειρήνη πάση. Εκ του κατά Ματθαίον Αγίου Ευαγγελίου το ανάγνωσμα πρόσχομαι.
Δόξα σοι, Κύριε, δόξα σοι.
Το καιρό εκείνο προσκαλεσάμενος ο Ιησούς τους 12 μαθητάς αυτού, έδωκεν αυτής εξουσίαν κατά πνευμάτων ακαθάρτων, ώστε εκβάλλειν αυτά και θεραπεύειν πάσαν νόσων και πάσαν ασθένειαν. Τούτους απέστειλεν ο Ιησούς παραγγείλας αυτής λέγον, εισοδών εθνών μη απέλθητε και εις πόλην Σαμαριτών μη εισέλθητε. Πορεύεστε μάλλον προς τα πρόβατα τα πολλολότα οίκου Ισραήλ. Πορευόμενοι δε κηρύσσετε λέγοντες, οντίγκηκεν η βασιλεία των ουρανών. Ασθενούντας θεραπεύετε, λεπρούς καθαρίζετε, νεκρούς εγείρετε, δαιμόνια εκβάλλετε, δωρεάν ελάβετε, δωρεάν δότε. Ελέησον ημάς ο Θεός κατά το μέγα ελέος ο Θεομεθά σου επάκουσον και ελέησον.
Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον.
Έτσι δεόμεθα υπερ ελέου ζωής, ειρήνης, υγείας, σωτηρίας, επισκέψεως, συγχωρήσεως και αφέσεως των μαρτιών των δούλων του Θεού, πάντων των προσελθόντων εν το Αγίο Μυστηρίο τούτο, και υπέρ του συγχωρηθήνε αυτής, πάν πλημέλημα εκουσιώντε και ακούσιον.
Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον.
Ότι ελεήμων και φιλάνθρωπος Θεός υπάρχεις, και εσύ την δόξα να αναπέμπομεν το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Αγίο Πνεύματι νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Let us pray to the
Lord.
O Master Almighty, Holy King, who chastens yet does not put to death, who supports those who fall and raises those who are downtrodden, who heals our physical afflictions, we entreat you, our God, that you bring your mercy on this oil and to those who are anointed with it in your name, that it may be effectual unto the healing of soul and body, unto cleansing and deliverance from every infirmity, illness, malady, and every defilement of body and soul. Yes, Lord, send down from heaven your healing power, touch the body, quench the fever, soothe the pain, and banish every hidden ailment. Become the physician of these your servants. Raise them up and heal their suffering. Grant that they may be given to the church whole and in restored health. pleasing you and abiding by your will. For yours it is to show mercy and to save us. O our God, and to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us be attentive.
Εν η αν ημέρα επικαλέσουμε σε ταχύ επάκουσον μου, Κύριε εις άκουσον της προσευχής μου.
Σοφία.
Προς Κορινθίους Δευτέρας Επιστολής Παύλου το ανάγνωσμα.
Πρόσχομεν.
Αδελφοί, ημείς ναός Θεού έστε ζώντος, καθώς είπεν ο Θεός, ότι εν οικίσω εν αυτής, και εμπειρηπατήσω και έσω με αυτόν Θεός και αυτοί έσονται μη λαός. Διό εξέλθετε εκ μέσου αυτών και αφορίσθητε, λέγει Κύριος, και ακαθάρτου μη άπτεσθε, καγόης δέξομαι ημάς, και έσομε ημίν εις Πατέρα και ημίς εσεσθέμι εις Υιούς και Θυγατέρας, λέγει Κύριος Πανδοκράτορ, ταύτα σουν έχοντες τας επαγγελίας αγαπητή, καθαρίσομεν εαυτής από παντός μολυσμού σαρκός και πνεύματος, επιτελούντες αγιοσύνη εν φόβο Θεού.
Ειρήνη σοι.
Αλληλούια, αλληλούια, αλληλούια.
Wisdom, let us arise, let us hear the Holy Gospel, peace be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Readings from the Gospel according to Matthew, let us be attentive.
Glory to you, O Lord, glory to you.
At that time when Jesus entered Peter's house, he saw his mother-in-law lying sick with a fever. He touched her hand and the fever left her, and she rose and served him. That evening they brought to him many who were possessed with demons, and he cast out the spirits with a word and healed all who were sick. This was to fulfill what was spoken by the prophet Isaiah. He took our infirmities and bore our diseases. Now when Jesus saw great crowds around him, he gave orders to go over to the other side. And a scribe came up and said to him, "Teacher, I will follow you wherever you go." And Jesus said to him, "Foxes have holes, and birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head." Another of the disciples said to him, "Lord, let me first go and bury my father." But Jesus said to him, "Follow me, and leave the dead to bury their own dead." And when he entered the boat, his disciples followed him. Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy, we pray to you. Hear us and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again we pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, protection, and forgiveness of sins for the servants of God, those who are attending this holy sacrament from near or afar, and for the remission of all their sins, whether deliberate or unintended.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
For you are a merciful God who loves humankind, and to you we offer glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O gracious, loving, compassionate, and ever merciful Lord, plentiful in mercy and rich in beneficence, the Father of mercies and God of all comfort, who through your holy apostles have empowered us to heal the infirmities of your people by oil and prayer, confirm this oil unto the healing of those who shall be anointed with it, for relief from every ailment and every malady, for deliverance from evils of those who in firm hope await salvation from you. Yes, O Master Lord our God, we pray to you, the Almighty, that you will save us all. O only Physician of souls and bodies, sanctify us all. As healer of every malady, heal also these your servants. Raise them up from any bed of pain through the mercies of your goodness. Visit them in your mercy and compassion. Cast out from them every sickness and malady, so that being healed by your mighty hand, they may serve you with all thanksgiving, that even now, sharing in your ineffable love, we may sing praises and glorify you, who do great and wondrous things, both glorious and transcendent. For yours it is to show mercy and to save us, O our God, and to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us be attentive.
You shall guard us, O Lord, you shall preserve us. Save me, O Lord, for the holy man has ceased.
Wisdom.
The reading is from Paul's second letter to the Corinthians.
Let us be attentive.
Brethren, we do not want you to be ignorant, brethren, of the affliction we experienced in Asia, for we were so utterly, unbearably crushed that we despaired of life itself. Why, we felt that we had received the sentence of death, but that was to make us rely not on ourselves, but on God who raises the dead. He delivered us from so deadly a peril, and he will deliver us. On him we have set our hope, that he will deliver us again. You also must help us by prayer, so that many will give thanks on our behalf for the blessing granted us in answer to many prayers.
Peace be with you, the reader.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Sophia, ορθή, ακούσμεν του Αγίου Ευαγγελίου, ειρήνη πάση.
Και το πνεύμα Θεού.
Εκ του κατά Ματθαίον Αγίου Ευαγγελίου το ανάγνωσμα πρόσχομαι.
Δόξα σοι, Κύριε, δόξα σοι.
Είπεν ο Κύριος την παραβολήν ταύτην. Ομοιώθη η βασιλεία των ουρανών 10 παρθένης, έτινες λαβούσε τας λαμπάδας αυτών εξήλθον εις απάντησιν του νυμφίου. 5 δε ήσαν εξ αυτών φρόνιμοι και 5 μωρέ. Έτινες μωρέ λαβούσα λαβούσε τας λαμπάδας σε αυτόν, ουκ έλαβον με θε αυτόν έλεον. Εδε φρόνιμοι έλαβον έλεον εν της αγγύης αυτών, μετά των λαμπάδων αυτών. Χρονίζοντος δε του νυμφίου ενίσταξαν πάσε και εκάθευδον. Μέσης δε νυκτός κραυγή γέγονεν, ιδού ο νυμφίος έρχεται, εξέρχεστε εις απάντησιν αυτού. Τότε γέρθησαν πάσε επαρθένοι εκείνε, και εκόσμησαν τας λαμπάδας αυτών. Εδε μωρέτες φρονίμης είπων, δότε ημίν εκ του ελαίου ημών, ότι ελαμπάδες ημών σβαίνινται. Απεκρίθησαν δε εφρόνιμοι λέγουσε, μη ποτέ ου καρκέσι ημίν και ημίν. Πορεύεστε δε μάλλον προς τους πολλούντας και αγοράσατε εαυτές. Απερχομένων δε αυτών αγοράσε, ήλθεν ο νυμφίος και εέτοιμοι εισήλθον με ταυτού εις τους γάμους και εκλείστη η θύρα. Ύστερον δε έρχονται και ελλειπή οι παρθένοι, λέγουσε, «Κύριε, Κύριε, άνοιξον ημίν». Ο δε αποκριθής είπεν, «Αμήν λέγω ημίν, ούκ είδα ημάς».
Γρηγορείτεουν, ότι ούκ είδατε την ημέραν, ουδέ την ώραν, εν ή ο Υιός του ανθρώπου έρχεται.
Ελέησον ημάς ο Θεός κατά το μέγα ελαιός σου δεόμεθά σου επάκουσον και ελέησον.
Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον.
Έτι δεόμεθα υπερελέγου ζωής, ειρήνης, υγείας, σωτηρίας, επισκέψεως, συγχωρήσεως και αφέσεως των αμαρτιών των δούλων του Θεού, πάντων των προσελθόντων, εν το Αγίο Μυστηρίο τούτο και υπέρ του συγχωρηθήνε αυτής παν πλημέλημα εκούσιον τε και ακούσιον.
Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον.
Ότι ελεήμων και φιλάνθρωπος Θεός υπάρχεις και συ την δόξα να αναπέμπομε το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Αγίο Πνεύμα την ειν και αΐν και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord our God, you chasten and again heal. You lift the indigent from the ground and dunghill. Father of orphans and haven of tempest-tossed, physician of the ailing, who without toil bears our weaknesses and accepts our infirmities, it is you who cheerfully show mercy and pass over our iniquities, taking away our unrighteousness, quick to help and slow to wrath. You blew upon your disciples and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven." It is you who accept the repentance of sinners and have the power to pardon countless and grievous sins, bestowing healing upon all who continue in weakness and long-enduring illness. It is you, Lord, who have also called me, your humble, sinful, and unworthy servant, caught up in many sins and wallowing in the pleasures of life, to the holy and exceedingly lofty degree of the priesthood, and to enter within the innermost veil, into the Holy of Holies, where the holy angels only desire to penetrate and hear the voice of the Lord God announcing glad tidings, and to behold with their own eyes the presence of the sacred oblation, and to enjoy the divine and sacred liturgy. You, Lord, deemed me worthy to minister your heavenly mysteries and offer you gifts and sacrifices for our sins and the ignorances of people, and to mediate for your reason-endowed sheep, so that through your great and ineffable love for humankind, you may blot out their transgressions. All merciful King, hear the voice of my prayer at this hour and holy day, and at all times and places, and to these your servants who are ailing in soul and body, grant your healing, remitting their sins and pardoning their transgressions, both voluntary and involuntary, treating their incurable wounds and every ailment and malady. Give health to their souls. You who touched Peter's mother-in-law, who, having been cured of her fever, arose and ministered to you, O Master, grant healing and deliverance from every devastating pain to these your servants. Remember your mercies and compassion, and that the mind of man inclines toward evil from his youth, that no one is without sin upon earth, for you alone are without sin. You came and saved the human race and set us free from the bondage of the enemy. For if you enter into judgment with your servants, none will be found clean from stain, but every mouth shall be sealed, not having any defense. For as discarded rags is all our righteousness before you. Therefore, O Lord, do not remember the sins of our youth. For you are the hope of the hopeless, and the rest of those who labor and are heavy laden with iniquity. And to you we ascribe glory together with your Father, who is from everlasting, and your all-holy and life-giving Spirit, now and forever and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Proskomen.
Have mercy on me, O God, according to your great mercy. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me.
Wisdom.
The reading is from Paul's letter to the Galatians.
Let us be attentive.
Brethren,
The fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such there is no law. And those who belong to Christ Jesus have crucified the flesh with its passions and desires. If we live by the Spirit, let us also walk by the Spirit. Let us have no self-conceit, no provoking of one another, no envy of one another. Brethren, if a man is overtaken in any trespass, you who are spiritual should restore him in a spirit of gentleness. Look to yourself, lest you too be tempted. Bear one another's burdens, and so fulfill the law of Christ.
Peace be with you, the reader.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Σοφία ορθή ακούσμεν του Αγίου Ευαγγελίου, ειρήνη πάση.
Και το πνεύματι σου.
Εκ του κατά Ματθαίον Αγίου Ευαγγελίου το ανάγνωσμα πρόσχομαι.
Δόξα σοι Κύριε, δόξα σοι.
Το καιρό εκείνο εξήλθεν ο Ιησούς εις τα μέρη Τύρου και Σιδώνος και ειδού γινήχανα νέα από τον ορίον εκείνων εξελθούσα, εκράβγασεν αυτό λέγουσα, ελέησόν με Κύριε Ιε Δαβίδ, η θυγάτηρ μου κακός δαιμονίζεται, ο δε ούκ απεκρίθη αυτή λόγον. Και προσελθόντες οι μαθητέ αυτού, οι ρώτων αυτών λέγοντες, απόλυσον αυτήν, ότι κράζει όπισθεν ημών. Ο δε αποκριθής είπεν, ουκ απεστάλην ημίν εις τα πρόβατα τα απολωλώτα οίκου Ισραήλ. Η δε ελθούσα προς εκείνη αυτό λέγουσα, Κύριε βοήθημη. Ο δε αποκριθής είπεν, ουκ εστί καλόν λαβήν των άρτων των τέκνων και βαλήν της κιναρίης. Η δε είπε, ναι Κύριε, και γαρτακινάρια εστί από τον ψυχίον των πιπτόντων από τις τραπέζεις των Κυρίων αυτών. Τότε αποκριθείς ο Ιησούς είπεν αυτή, ω γίνε, μεγάλη σου η πίστης, γεννηθήτωση ως θέλεις, και η άθη η θυγάτηρ αυτής από της ώρας εκείνη.
Mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy, we pray to you, hear us and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
We pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, protection and forgiveness of sins for the servants of God, those who are attending this holy sacrament from near and afar, and for the remission of all their sins, both voluntary and involuntary.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
For you are a merciful God who loves humankind, and to you we offer glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Κυρίου δεϊθόμεν.
Ευχαριστούμεν Συ Κύριε ο Θεός ημών ο αγαθός και φιλάνθρωπος και ιατρός των ψυχών και των σωμάτων ημών. Οτας νόσους ημών απόνος βαστάζων, ούτω μόλοπι πάντες οι άθημεν, ο ποιμήν ο καλός, ο εις αναζήτησιν ελθόν του πλανηθέντος προβάτου, ο της ολιγοψύχης διδούς παραμυθίαν και ζωήν της συντετριμένης, ο την πηγήν της αιμορροούσης δωδεκαετίους ανιασάμενος, ο την θυγατέρα της Χαναναίας του χαλεπού δαιμονίου ελευθερώσας, ο το δάνειον χαρισάμενος της δυσή χρεοφυλέτες και τη αμαρτωλό την άφεσιν δούς, ο την ίασιν του παραλυτικό δωρισάμενος συνδιαφέσει των αμαρτιών αυτού, ο τον τελώνειν το λόγο δικαιώσας και τον ληστείν εν διεσχάτη αυτού ομολογία προσδεξάμενος, ο τας αμαρτίας του κόσμου αράμενος και το σταυρό προσιλώσας, σου δεόμεθα και σε οικετεύομαι. εν τη αγαθότητή σου αυτός άνες άφε συγχώρησον Θεός τας ανομίας και τας αμαρτίας των δούλων σου τούτων, τα πλημελήματα αυτών, τα εκούσια και τα ακούσια, τα εν γνώση και εν αγνία, τα εν παραβάση και εν παρακοή, τα εν νυχτή και εν ημέρα, ή υποκατάραν ιερέως, η πατρός, η μητρός εγένοντο, ή οφθαλμόν εστίασαν, ή όσφρησιν εξεθύλιναν, ή αφή κατεμαλακίστησαν, ή γεύση κατεπόρνευσαν, ή ενιαδήποτε κινήσεις αρκός και πνεύματος του σου απειλοτριώθησαν θελήματος και της εις αγιότητος. Ή τι ήμαρτον, αυτήτε και εμείς ως αγαθός και αμνησί κακός Θεός και φιλάνθρωπος, συγχώρησον. Μη αιών αυτούς και ημάς εις των ρεριπωμένων βίων καταπεσίν, μη δε εις τας ολεθρίους οδούς αποτρέχειν. Ναι, δέσποτα Κύριε, επάκουσον μου το αμαρτωλού εν τη ώρα ταύτη υπέρ των δούλων σου τούτων, πάρει δε ως αμνησί κακός Θεός τα παραπτώματα αυτών άπαντα, απάλαξον αυτούς της αιωνίου κολάσεως, το στόμα αυτών της εις ενέσεως πλήρωσον, τα χείλη αυτών άνοιξον προς δοξολογίαν του ονόματός σου, τα σχήρας αυτών έκτινον προς εργασίαν των εντολών σου, τους πόδες αυτών προς τον δρόμο του Ευαγγελίου σου κατεύθυνον, πάντα αυτών τα μέλη και την διάνοια της εί κατασφαλιζόμενος χάριτη. Σίγαρη ο Θεός ημών, ο δια των Αγίων σου Αποστόλων εντυλάμινος ημίν λέγον, όσα αν δύσετε επί της γης έστε δεδεμένα εν της ουρανής, και όσα αν λύσετε επί της γης έστε λελειμμένα εν της ουρανής. Και πάλιν, αν την ον αφείτε τας αμαρτίας αφίενται αυτής, αν την ον κρατείτε και κράτηνται. Και ως επίκουσας Εζεκίου εν τη θλίψη της ψυχής αυτού, εν τη ώρα του θανάτου αυτού, και ού παρίδες την δέησιν αυτού, ούτω καμού του ταπεινού και αμαρτωλού και αναξίου δούλου σου, επάκουσον εν τη ώρα ταύτη δεωμένου σου. Σίγαρη Κύριε Ιησού Χριστέ, ο εβδομικοντάκης επτά αφιέν της περιπίπτουσιν εν αμαρτίες και λεύσας, της ή αγαθότητη και φιλανθρωπία, και μετανοών επί της κακίες ημών, και χαίρον επί τη επιστροφή των πεπλανημένων, ότι ως η μεγαλοσύνη σου, ούτω και το έλεό σου. Και εσύ την δόξα να αναπέμπομεν συν το ανάρχο σου Πατρί και του Παναγίου και αγαθό, και ζωπιό σου πνεύματι νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Πρόσχομεν.
The Lord do not reprove me in your anger. Have mercy on me, O Lord, for I am weak.
Σοφία.
The reading is from Paul's first letter to the Thessalonians.
Let us be attentive.
Brethren, we exhort you, admonish the idlers, encourage the faint-hearted, help the weak, be patient with them all. See that none of you repays evil for evil, but repay, but always seek to do good to one another and to all. Rejoice always, pray constantly, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Do not quench the Spirit, do not despise prophesying, but test everything. Hold fast what is good, abstain from every evil form of evil. May the God of peace himself sanctify you wholly, and may your spirit and soul and body be kept sound and blameless at the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Peace be with you, the reader.
Hallelujah.
Wisdom, arise, let us hear the Holy Gospel. Peace be with you all.
And with your spirit.
The reading is from the Gospel according to Matthew. Let us be attentive.
Glory to you, O Lord, glory to you.
At that time, as Jesus passed on from there, he saw a man called Matthew sitting at the tax office. And he said to him, "Follow me." And he rose and followed him. And as he sat at table in the house, behold, many tax collectors and sinners came and sat down with Jesus and his disciples. When the Pharisees saw this, they said to his disciples, "Why does your teacher eat with tax collectors and sinners?" But when he heard it, he said, "Those who are well have no need of a physician, but those who are sick. Go and learn what this means. I desire mercy and not sacrifice, for I came not to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance."
Glory to you, Lord. Glory to you.
Ελέησον ημάς ο Θεός κατά το μέγα ελαιό σου, δεόμεθά σου επάκουσον και ελέησον. Έτι δεόμεθα υπερελαίου ζωής, ειρήνης, υγείας, σωτηρίας, επισκέψεως, συγχωρήσεως και αφέσεως των αμαρτιών των δούλων του Θεού, πάντων των προσελθόντων εν το Αγίο Μυστήριο τούτο, και υπέρ του συγχωρηθήνε αυτής, πάν πλημέλημα εκούσιον τε και ακούσιον. Ότι ελεήμων και φιλάνθρωπος Θεός υπάρχεις, και εσύ την δόξα να αναπέμπομεν, το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Άγιο Πνεύματι, νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O Master, Lord our God, physician of souls and bodies, it is you who soothe the chronic pains and heal every infirmity and malady of the people. You desire that all should be saved and come to the knowledge of the truth, and you will not the death of the sinner, but rather that he should repent and live. For you, O Lord, in the Old Testament ordained repentance for sinners, for David and the Ninevites, and for those before and after them, but also in the new dispensation of your coming in the flesh, you called not the righteous, but the sinners to repentance, like the publican, the harlot, the robber, and the blasphemer and great persecutor Paul, receiving them all through repentance. Peter, your great apostle, who denied you three times, you received in repentance, and promised him, saying, "You are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades shall not prevail against it, and I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven." Therefore, O merciful and loving God, encouraged by your faithful promise, we pray and entreat you at this hour, hear our prayer and accept it as incense offered to you. Visit your servants, both near and afar, and if they have transgressed in either word or deed or thought, by night or by day, if they have come under the curse of a priest or their own anathema, or have sworn an oath, we pray to you, release, pardon, and forgive them, O God, overlooking their transgressions and their sins committed by them knowingly or in ignorance. And if they have transgressed your commandments or have erred, as bearing flesh and living in the world, or by the prompting of the devil, forgive them as a merciful and loving God. For there is no man who lives and does not sin. Only you are sinless. Your righteousness is to all eternity, and your word is truth. You did not create man for destruction, but for the keeping of your commandments and to inherit life incorruptible. To you we ascribe glory together with your Father, who is from everlasting, and your all-holy, good and life-giving Spirit now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
To Kyrie Eleison.
Πάτερ Άγιε, Ιατρέ των ψυχών και των σωμάτων, ο πέμψας των μονογενή Σου Υιών, των Κύριων ημών Ιησούν Χριστών, πάσα νόσων ιόμενων και εκ θανάτου λυτρούμενων, ίασε τους δούλους Σου, εκ της περιεχούσης αυτών σωματικής ή ψυχικής ασθενείας, και ζωοποίησον αυτούς δια της χάριτος του Χριστού Σου. Πρεσβείες της Περαγίας Δεσποίνης ημών Θεοτόκου και Αϊπαρθένου Μαρίας, δυνάμει του Τιμίου και Ζωοποιού Σταυρού, προστασίες των Τιμίων Επουρανίων Δυνάμεων Ασωμάτων, του Τιμίου Ενδόξου Προφήτου Προδρόμου και Βαπτιστού Ιωάννου, των Αγίων Ενδόξων και Πανεφήμων Αποστόλων, των Αγίων Ενδόξων και Καλλινίκων Μαρτύρων, των Οσίων και Θεοφόρων Πατέρων ημών, των Αγίων και Ιαματικών Αναργύρων, Κοσμά και Δαμιανού, Κύρου και Ιωάννου, Παντελεήμνος και Ερμολάου, Σαμψών και Διομήδους, Μοκίου και Ανικήτου, Θαλελαίου και Τρίφωνος, των Αγίων και Δικαίων Θεοπατώρων, Ιωακήμ και Άνης και πάντων των Αγίων. Ότι σύ πηγή των Ιαμάτων ο Θεός ημών, και σύ την δόξαν αναπέμπομεν, το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Αγίο Πνεύματι, νυν και αΐν, και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Amen.
Glory to you, our God, glory to you.
Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and forever and in the ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Holy Father, bless.
Christ, our true God, through the intercessions of His all-pure and all-immaculate Holy Mother, the power of the precious and life-giving cross, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and Saint James, the Lord's brother, and of all the saints, through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us. Brothers and sisters, we are calling this crisis that we're going through a health crisis. And I'd like to just dwell on the word health and other related concepts. This service, the service of healing oil, or ευχέλαιον, as it is known in Greek, speaks about health constantly. The last gospel reading which we read, there were seven of them, the last one we read has Jesus responding to a criticism that was leveled at him by the Pharisees. The Pharisees being a religious order, and who, upon seeing Jesus sit at table and have acquaintances, many tax collectors and other people who were considered bad people in that society, they criticized Jesus, saying to his disciples, "Why does your teacher eat with tax collectors and sinners?" Now, this is an interesting question which probably we may not understand why this religious order would have asked this question, but we can try and understand and consider this, that in other passages of the Bible, we see the Pharisees as not just a religious order, but a religious order which was obsessing about some of the religious duties and other religious customs that they expected all Jewish people to be doing without exception. And Jesus has a lot to say against the Pharisees as a religious order, especially of the fact that they are hypocritical. They say one thing, do another. They ask difficult things of the people. They like to show off their presence in public, have the best seats in public gatherings, and so on. And Jesus has a lot of criticism for the Pharisees. Now he responds to the specific criticism that was leveled at him by the Pharisees by saying, "Those who are well have no need of a physician, but those who are sick." And the Greek is "ούχριαν έχουσιν ισχύοντες ιατρού." Those who are well, those who are strong, those who are healthy, do not need a doctor. But those who are sick, αλικακός έχοντες. Now it is interesting that the Greek there is κακός έχοντες, which is not only applicable to health, as in sickness per se, it includes sickness, but it also includes other things that we might be suffering from that may not be specifically diseases or illnesses. There are other pathologies that we as human beings have, especially behavioral pathologies that we all are challenged with, and that need not be diagnosed either. He goes on and says, go and learn what this means, and he quotes the Old Testament. I desire mercy and not sacrifice. I desire mercy and not sacrifice. The Greek is eleon thelo ke uthisian. A beautiful phrase, I believe, from Isaiah. Eleon thelo ke ou thisian. You see, what God is saying both in the Old Testament, in the specific prophetic vision where that quote comes from, as well as Jesus saying it here, is that don't be judging. Don't be so narrow-minded. Don't be so picky. Put that aside for a moment. But this can also apply to don't be dwelling on the surface, but try and seek the essence. This is very, very important, because our sacrifice, our sacrifices, our religious propriety, our properness may not be acceptable sacrifice to God's eyes. He prefers mercy. He prefers to see us loving and understanding of difficult situations. So the Greek for mercy is eleon. This is extremely important to understand this word eleon. And it is related to eleon, as in mercy, eleon, as in oil, and therefore a means of healing. And it is connected to all these Indo-European words, health, healing, and wholeness. So when God says eleon thelo, we should understand that as more than mercy. I want to see mercy from you. I want to see you healed. I don't want to see you troubled. I don't want to see you in turmoil, inner spiritual turmoil. I want to see you in peace. I want you to open your hearts and receive this spiritual health. Which brings me to the next point, as I am connecting the situation both of the Evangelion service, this specific gospel reading, and what we are experiencing now. We are essentially unable to attend church, and that hurts. We are essentially, as Christians, unable to take Holy Communion, participate fully in the services of the church and the public gatherings and the common prayer that gives us so much strength for every time of our life, and more so we need it now. And thank goodness we have technology and we can live stream our service and spread the message even from afar. And I'd like to bring your attention to a specific canon that the Orthodox Church abides by in these extraneous situations. This is not normal circumstance. Living through a pandemic, an epidemic, a plague, it is not normal. And so certain things have to be done that are not normal for us. The canon is canon number 88 from the Sixth Ecumenical Council held in Trullo, which is a suburb of Constantinople, and it is otherwise known as the Fifth Sixth Ecumenical Council, in that it brought together those two ecumenical councils. It starts off by quoting Jesus himself, the Lord Jesus, saying that the Sabbath was created for man and not man for the Sabbath. And so what the Church Fathers do in this specific canon is that they say that what we have to prioritize in all considerations, where we have multiple canons to consider and weigh up, multiple duties as a religious community to abide by, that we should always prioritize the health and salvation and well-being of the people, of humanity. In other words, there are canons which say we should be communing on a regular basis. There are canons, rules, and regulations within the church community that preach and teach that we should not miss out on church more than 3 Sundays in a row, 3 consecutive Sundays. There are canons, guidelines, and regulations which tell us that we should be doing this. However, what Canon 88 does is says to us, but when the health, well-being, and salvation of souls is concerned, that has to come first, and the rest can follow where practical. Now, this can be a difficult balance, but it is a good principle to consider at this time, because all of us understand as Christians that there is no greater love to have than to die for the other. In other words, we don't think of ourselves as Christians. We pray for ourselves last. We think of the others. We think of the people within our community and our society. So, in a time of pestilence and of an epidemic, we need to consider the safety and health of others. We have a specific problem here with the coronavirus, that people are asymptomatic. In other words, don't show symptoms so we feel perfectly fine, there's nothing wrong with me, I will go out and do my thing. You can understand how selfish that can be, because we may have the virus and are giving it to other people. Now, I'm stating the obvious here that we should all be understanding. And now, as Christians, we should not have the arrogance to say, I feel fine, I will go and do my thing. That shows that we are inconsiderate and that we have learnt nothing from our Christian upbringing and our principles, which teach that we should be ready to die for the other, not let me do my thing. So therefore, Canon 88 of the Sixth Ecumenical Council prioritizes the health and well-being of humanity, of the people of our community, and of the wider society, above and beyond what is our duty as Christians. We cannot be in the position of the Pharisees who are criticizing Jesus, who broke the Sabbath technically, and they criticized him for it. We need to abide by Jesus' principles. He was the one who says the Sabbath was created for man and not man for the Sabbath. He technically broke the rules. So let us be with Jesus and not with the Pharisees in this extraneous, difficult, and out of the normal circumstance. I hope that I have explained things for you to consider. Please look up the canon for yourselves. It uses the words apatheia in describing well-being. We don't want our fellow human beings to suffer. Pathos is the word for suffering, and therefore apatheia in this context means non-suffering. We don't want people to suffer. And may all of us, with humility and understanding of these principles, consider what our priorities are. I pray for all of you and your families, for healing both physical and spiritual, and we pray for the healing of the entire world's population from this specific problem that we are undergoing. I thank you for your patience.